Late 1800s France. After the colourful, jubilant celebration of youthful love between a young couple, Jeanne and Jacques, Jeanne is raped and humiliated by a feudal lord, leaving her demeaned. The relationship between Jeanne and Jean in a disturbed state. At her lowest point, banished from the village, Jeanne finally agrees to a pact with a phallic demon who grants her the influence and power to rule over the village and celebrate pure carnal lust. This is Aichi Yamamoto's Belladonna of Sadness, a kaleidoscopic hallucinatory animated film that pushes its protagonist, Jeanne, into the recesses of misery before she is aided in the reach for lustful heights. An adult anime film filled with explicit nudity and sexual violence, Belladonna of Sadness is also incredibly distinctive for its use of watercolour paintings, murals, and its expressive illustrated still frames, sometimes incorporated with fluid and at other times limited animation. It's an aesthetic that avoids the expensive animation of Mamoru Oshii's Ghost in a Shell or Katsuhiro Otomo's Akira, but this limitation does not dilute the film's artistic impact. Each frame, still or animated, has an expressive painterly quality, beautifully framed characters and attention to minute details such as Jeanne's hair and lips, to the complicated flurry of a hustle and bustle. The aesthetic of Belladonna of Sadness is undeniably inventive and passionate, intimate and emotional, with Jeanne's pained expression told through her eyes. A clear example of her pain is demonstrated. Similarly, in times when Jeanne is in control, her expressions are often stoic, almost quietly playful, as she is master manipulator of the village's orgiastic delights. To leave these expressions in beautifully painted still images allows the viewer's own imagination to fill in the blanks, the character expressions and movements we do not see. However, that's not to say the violence and sex in Belladonna of Sadness lacks impact. During the sequence when the feudal lord has his way with Jeanne, a graphic depiction of violation and sexual intrusion is depicted by a deep animated thrusting motion in a shocking stark red to indicate pain and blood, which illustrates Jeanne's further suffering as she returns home, bleeding from between her legs. This is a vivid portrayal of sexual abuse, explicit and yet also abstract, shocking and yet almost hallucinatory. It's a disturbing portrayal of violence, pushing Jeanne into the depths of misery as she faces rejection from the village and even assault from her own husband. These are uncomfortable, shocking moments to watch, and although they verge on gratuitous, it serves to establish a strong contrast between Jeanne's early vulnerabilities and later in the film, her confidence, power, and influence to inspire a village into orgiastic hedonism and eventual solidarity and unity. As the phallic demon provides Jeanne with the source of power, bringing the joys of sex to her village, smashing the taboos and stigma surrounding recreational sex, undermining the judgment of religion condemning pleasure and sex as a sin, the feudal lord is intimidated by Jeanne's influence strengthening over his, and sentences her to be burned at the stake for witchcraft. As she burns, we watch as villagers' faces change to Jeanne's face, indicating a sense of solidarity with Jeanne and her suffering. These people, specifically the women, have suffered the most under tyrannical patriarchal ruling. The women have often been the secondary subordinate citizens, left alone and marginalized as the men went to war, and seeing their liberator Jeanne burn at the stake awakens a sense of unity with them. Even Jean, Jeanne's troubled husband, attempts to avenge her execution, failing miserably. In her strengthened state as a goddess of lust, a promoter of sex positivity, and in her final state as a demeaned victim of execution, Jeanne has the final say against the oppressive powers of the feudal lord. In her ability to unite the village in her promotion of sex positivity, in her support of sexual liberation of the village's women, taking sex into their own hands, and on their own terms, she has motivated and inspired them to take a stance against oppressive patriarchy. Rulership. Belladonna of Sadness comes to a conclusion that's surprisingly powerful and offers a message of feminist empowerment. During the storming of the Bastille, an attack on a Parisian prison, the prison being viewed as a symbol of the dictatorial rule of the monarchy, the event acting as a catalyst to the French Revolution, the film portrays the women at the forefront of this revolution, celebrating their contribution to French liberation. It's a powerful moment that places the extreme suffering depicted earlier in the film and perspective. With all that women must endure, it's only a matter of time when they will retaliate back, and united, women are a strong force for liberation. In conclusion, Aichi Yamamoto's Belladonna of Sadness, despite its moments of extreme violence, the film offers a surprisingly feminist message that through suffering, women have united and become a strength and empowered force against patriarchal tyranny, such as the feudal lord who serves as the antagonist to Jeanne's redemption as a sexual liberator. Belladonna of Sadness encourages sex positivity, embracing the pleasure and removing the stigma enforced by patriarchy and conservative faith, while also supporting the solidarity of women against dictatorship. Its painterly psychedelic art style is visually beautiful, suggesting the film to be a hallucinatory thrill ride, but Belladonna of Sadness is truly something so much more.